But the Senator from California relied on the 2006 Stern report from Britain to bolster her claim. This is a very important moment in time, the cost of doing nothing, according to the leading economists on this subject in the world. Nicholas Stern is five times what the cost would be to address the issue now. Now, I do think this is worth spending a little bit of time on because my good friend, the junior senator from California, spent quite a bit of time on this subject. What do the experts say about the Stern report? The economist Richard Toll of Hamburg University, one of the world's leading environmental economists, tore apart the Stern report on January 26, saying, quote, if a student of mine were to hand in this report on a master's thesis, it is likely I would give him an F for failure. There is a whole range of basic economics mistakes that someone who claims to be a professor of economics simply should not make. Toll said, according to the BBC, Stern consistently picks up the most pessimistic of every choice that one can make. He overstates through cherry picking. He double counts, particularly the risk that he underestimates what development adaptation would do to impacts. Danish statistician Bjorn Lomborg critiqued the Stern report in a November of 06 Wall Street Journal op-ed piece. He said, the report seems hastily put together with many sloppy errors. As an example, the cost of hurricanes in the United States is said to be 0.13% of U.S. GDP and 10 times that figure, Lomborg wrote. It seems, quoting further now, naive to believe that the world's 92 nations can flawlessly implement Mr. Stern's multi-trillion-dollar, century-long policy proposal. Will nobody try to avoid its obligations? Why would China and India ever participate, particularly when they've stated that they would not do it? Roger Pilkey, the director of the University of Colorado Center for Science and Technology Policy Research, also chided the Stern report for cherry-picking data on October 30th of 06. The Stern report, I'm quoting now, selective fishing out of a convenient statement from one of the background papers prepared for our workshop is a classic example of cherry picking a result from a diversity of perspectives rather than focusing on the consensus of the entire spectrum of experts that participated in our meeting. Pilkey wrote, quoting further, he said, to support its argument, the Stern report further relies on the significantly flawed report from the Association of British Insurers, which we critiqued here. Its presentation of the future costs of disasters in climate change is highly selective, to put it mildly, he added. Australian paleoclimate scientist Dr. Bob Carter ridiculed the Stern report in a November 3rd, 06 article. Quote, the Stern report could join Paul Ehrlich's The Population Bomb in the Club of Roman Limits to Growth, Rome's Limits to Growth, and goes on in some detail criticizing the report, scientifically criticizing the report. Yale University's Sterling Professor of Economics, William Nordhaus, recently authored a study of the economic effects of climate change entitled The Challenge of Global Warming, Economic Models and Environmental Policy. The study revealed that so-called global warming solutions would cost two or even three times the benefits they would theoretically achieve. Nordhaus was specifically critical of Stern's use of novel methodology in which he assumes a near zero discount rate for dramatically increases the benefits of addressing global warming. And the New York Times captured the views of Main Street economists in its February 21st, 07 article by David Leonard when he cited Nordhaus's concerns, adding, and this is a quote, this was fairly tame compared to the comments of yet another Yale economist, Robert Mendelson, I was awestruck, he said, comparing Sir Nicholas Stern to the Wizard of Oz, but my job is to be Toto. It goes on and on and on. Even Alan Greenspan talks about spending quite a bit of time on, he said, there's no effective way to meaningfully reduce emissions without negatively impacting a larger part of the economy.